Hi guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Precious, and if this is your first time here, thank you for stopping by. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. So today I will be doing a part two of my Christmas and birthday haul. So the first time when I was recording the video, the part one, I had done like a live update video earlier in the day, and when I was recording this, I had quite a lot of stuff and I got tired midway. I just couldn't go on, so I said, you know what, let me put that to a stop and I will come back when I'm refreshed and do a part two. No one told me that making YouTube videos was so stressful, especially when you have to talk and talk and talk a lot. But anyways, I'm here for part two and I don't have so much stuff, but I mean, I did share a lot of more stuff in part one, but I have just a few stuff here to share. And if you want to see the part two of the video and the stuff that I have remaining, keep on watching. Okay, so I'll start off with the milk makeup pack. Let me just grab these. So this is what it looks like. This is what the carton looks like. Let me put it this way. So this is the package. This is what's inside. And let me take them out. So the first thing in here is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. This is my go-to primer. I really love this one. It is quite pricey, but during Black Friday they did have a, I think, 20% off sale of the full size, so I did get something saved off this. And I know we all know this primer, but I'll just do a little swatch on the back of my hand. So this is what it looks like. It's like a gel, like it has a gel like consistency, and it dries, and when you put your foundation on, it just grips your foundation into place. I really love it. It does help to control my oily skin, and I will always repurchase. This is a really good thing. I had to adjust the settings of my camera because it was a bit too zoomed out and I really didn't like the angle. So so let's move along. So the next product is the Milk Hydro Grip Spray. Now for this product, I have used it before and I must say it's not the best at controlling oily skin or setting the makeup, but it is really good at melting your makeup into your skin. So if you're going to get this, I would say use this as a finishing spray and then get another spray like the Morphe one or the Urban Decay one and use that to set your face, because this one does a good job at, you know, refreshing your skin and melting your makeup into place. But as a mattifying spray, no, I don't think that's its job. But it is really nice. I really like it. When I use this, all the powders just melt into place. It feels really nice on the skin. I really love it. This is a good one, and something that I always want to have in my makeup kit. This will be good for people who have dry skin. If you have dry skin and you use this, it will really help to melt your makeup and give you that skin like finish. But for someone like me who has oily skin, it's good. But then you can also go over it with like a mattifying spray to make sure that your makeup isn't slipping and sliding off your face. Yeah, so that's that.
Next item is from Sunday Riley. This is what it looks like, and this is what it looks like inside. So let me just put this down here somewhere. And these are all the items. Okay, so first thing I'm grabbing is the Sunday Riley A Plus High Dose Retinoid Serum. Let me get the other ones out before I go into talking about them. Oh, this is All About Oil Sunday Riley set. Now this packaging is just so beautiful, guys. Can you see how pretty this is? So in here we have the UFO Clear and Soothe with the Clear and Soothe with UFO, CEO Glow, Brighten and Nurture with CEO Glow, Luna Plump and Calm with Luna, and Juno Restore and Rehydrate. So this is the pack and these are the oils. These are all the oils inside. Like, the packaging is so pretty. This is so well thought out, honestly. I don't think I'm even gonna take it out of the pack. I'm just gonna put it on the my skincare display. Very pretty. Next are these two. These are the CEO Glow and Luna as well. These are 10 ml each. These ones here are 5 ml. They were on sale. The prices were great. I was like, you know what? Why not? Just grab them. And if you spend, I think, about $65 or $70, you would get free shipping. And I was like, why not? Let me just grab them. So those are the three. And I got samples. A lot of samples. A whole lot of samples.
So we have the sunscreen, See You Afterglow Ice Ceramide Moisturizing Cream, Autocorrect, Good Genes, all that. So I realized that I did not get any of the Good Genes, the lactic or glycolic acid, for some reason. I think I forgot. But yeah, these are what I have, and I can't wait to use these. So I have used the Luna sleeping night oil before, and it is very good. I know I had like very problematic skin that period, and I really didn't know much about it, but I knew I got a sample then, and I used it for like a week, and my skin was just so clear and bright and even, and I really enjoyed it. But I kept thinking, oh, it's so expensive, the full price is so expensive. And I had a Sunny Riley list that I had made, and I said whenever it's Black Friday, hopefully they have like really good sales and I will be able to jump on them, and they did. So I can't wait to use these oils. I haven't used anyone except the Luna one, so I don't have much to say about them. I can just take these ones out of the pack. So this is what the UFO oil looks like. It's supposed to be, so it has 1.5 salicylic acid, it exfoliates and clears congested pores. See Your Glow has advanced vitamin C, turmeric and evening primrose oil to brighten, hydrate and glow. Juno is an antioxidant and superfood facial oil with 9 cold pressed vitamin rich seed oils. And Luna is a sleeping night oil, which is a next generation retinoid oil, which helps to reduce the appearance of pores and wrinkles while fighting the signs of premature aging and surface redness. Okay, so all you need to know about these oils, if you're interested, you can grab them. I'll be sharing more skincare reviews and skincare routines on this channel, and I will definitely be incorporating these in my skincare routine. So yeah, that's that for that. Let me put these two back in, and let me come to this one. So I'm relatively new to retinol. I've always shied away from it because I hear reviews on, oh, I just started using retinol and I broke out, and your skin has to purge first before it starts getting better. And nobody wants to go through that. I don't, because I don't want my skin to be jacked up first before it gets better. I just want something that works. But I don't really have that much problematic skin, except for it being oily and the occasional breakout during my time of the month. And you know, sometimes you just break out. Your skin is it's an organism, so it does its thing sometimes. So I decided to try this one out. I had been using the Cosrx retinol, and I think that one was like 0.01%. It was really low, and my skin had been getting used to it, and I didn't break out. So I was like, oh, you know what, why don't you just go for something higher? And I said I would try this one. So what does this one say? This is an advanced strength retinoid serum delivering a 6.5% solution of stabilized retinoid blends and botanical retinol alternative extracts into the skin. So this is 6.5%. I know the Cosrx one is about 0.05 or 0.1%. This is really high, so you have to use this really lightly. I will be sandwiching this with other skincare products when I try it out, so it's not too much for my skin. I don't want to attack my skin with too much. And yeah, I can't wait to try this. I will be giving a review after I use this to share with you guys what I think about it. Okay guys, so the next thing I'm going to be showing are my Bath and Body Works candles. I am a huge candle lover. I have been buying candles for years. I love them. I love the way they make me feel. I love their scents. I don't think I've ever purchased a bad candle. I believe every candle is unique, and I enjoy it for what it is. So every year during Candle Day, I wait and I purchase all the candles that I use for a year. I try to buy at least a dozen, because that will last me through the year, and it's really cheap. So Bath and Body Works candles usually retail for about $25.60, but on Candle Day you can get them for $9.90. I mean the big ones. So I just wait and I load my card, and then I purchase my candles, and it's always such a good steal. So I'm gonna show you the candles that I got.
I think I should do a candle collection video as well, because I have quite a few still left in storage that I'm using currently, and I have these new ones that I've added. And I do repurchase some particular scents that I really love, but yeah, these ones are new scents, and I'm going to show you.
So this is the box here. This is one carton. This has 5 candles and 3 room sprays. I'm a huge fan of scents, so I love perfumes, I love my space to smell good, I love diffusers, all that jazz. So these are the 3 room sprays that I got. This is In the Stars Bath and Body Works, Champagne Toast, and Warm Vanilla Sugar. And one thing I love about Bath and Body Works sprays is that whatever the name says, if you can close your eyes and just dream, that's exactly what it will smell like warm vanilla sugar. Just imagine a melting pot of vanilla and sugar, like vanilla scent and sugar melting in a pot. That's the way it smells. No, I just absolutely love this. Like, so I got 3 of these. I will be getting more. And yeah, so that's that for that. Okay, so I'll just share the first set of Bath and Body Works candles that I have here. These ones are from the White Barn collection, and the first one is called Cypress and Amber. Ugh, that smells so good. I really love the sage green packaging of the candle. I think this line is more like the mature line for the Bath and Body Works candles, so to say. So what does this smell like? What are the fragrance notes? So this has dark cypress, smoked amber, fresh bergamot. Those are the 3 top notes. I noticed that most of the candles don't have more than 3 notes, so you can really pick out what you're smelling, and obviously, and of course, with natural essential oils. So oh, this is so pretty. It smells like a, it does smell, there is something very smoky about it, but it still smells slightly fresh. I think it's probably the amber. It has this subtle smokiness about it, and I really love this. Okay, so next one. The next one is cinnamon spiced vanilla. So let's guess what notes are there. Cinnamon, vanilla, something else, something spicy, and then natural essential oils. Okay, so we have fresh ground cinnamon, sugar crystals, Tahitian vanilla bean with natural essential oils. So sugar crystals is the third note here. Yeah, and it smells like cinnamon. The first note that hits you is the cinnamon, and then followed lightly by the vanilla. Smells like it would be the second note, but the cinnamon definitely just shines through. Alrighty, then the third one is White Woods and Peach. So we're gonna have something woody, and then definitely a peach and essential oil. So we have juicy peach, we have soft white woods, and cinnamon stick with natural essential oils. So you see, they stick to three different fragrance notes with natural essential oils. And this smells so good. It smells like a hair conditioner. It smells like something from Shea Moisture that I use in my hair, like a leave-in conditioner or something. It's really nice, really nice. It's not overpowering. It's just a soft whiff of something so soft and peachy. That's how I'll describe it. And then the last one is, oops, I think I grabbed Cypress Amber again. Okay, so the last one is Applewood and Clove. I love the packaging, gray with a gray cover, a gray lid, and a dark gray label. So this is Applewood and Clove, and the notes are rich applewood, warm clove, and white birch with natural essential oils. Beautiful. It's just, this line has really mature scents, like doesn't have like, I don't know how to describe it, but even from the packaging, you can tell this is a more mature line. It's very pretty, very understated. The packaging is simple. The notes are a little more refined. Oops. The notes are a little more refined, and I can't wait to burn these. So my phone memory ran out. So, and I have deleted and deleted. I don't have any space anymore. I made like 2 videos earlier, which were heavy. So I had to switch to my other phone, so the quality drops a little bit. No, I'm using a different device, but I'll just power through. I have just like one or two things left to show you. So the next batch of things I'm going to show are the other 5 candles I got. I'm just going to power through these. So this one is Bubbly Rose. Smells beautiful. Smells like a bubblegum strawberry or something, honestly. I love the packaging. It's like a fuchsia pink with this. Beautiful. That's one. I'm just gonna go through this real quickly. This is called Endless Weekend. I don't know how to describe what an endless weekend smells like, but this smells good as well. Bath and Body Works candles smell so good. Okay, so the fragrance notes are fresh summer mandarin, blue coconut water, sun-kissed magnolia. Okay. I know I see a lot of magnolia scents, but I don't really know what the scent smells like independently. But if it smells anything like that, it's really good. So Bubbly Rose, let me see. Pink Sparkling Rose, Sweet Blood Orange, Splash of Cranberry Juice with Natural Essential Oils. So that smells good. Moving on to the third one. This is Strawberry Pound Cake. And this has fresh picked strawberries, golden shortcake, and whipped cream. Okay. Absolutely. That's what it smells like. It does smell like a... It smells like a shortcake. Definitely. I love it. And I love the red packaging. Bath and Body Works, they nail it with their candles all the time. So the next one is Champagne Toast. I have repurchased this. This is my third Champagne Toast and the packaging is always different. I think the other one was from the White Barn collection. Smells good. Bubbly Champagne, Sparkling Berries, Sweet Orange. I do smell that citrus, just a light citrus burst in there. Very nice. And last but definitely not the least is called Aw, Butterfly. This packaging is so lovely. I love it. Okay, so this has raspberry nectar, iris petals, airy vanilla with natural essential oils. Just go straight to the head. I love this. Okay, so that's that for all the candles I got. Okay, so the last thing from Bath and Body Works is this Japanese cherry blossom fragrance mist. This is my second repurchase. I really like it. I think I saw it on Dimash channel and I purchased this and the candle. And the candle is so beautiful as well. So this has... What are the notes? So it doesn't have the notes, but I mean, it does smell like a cherry blossom. And I know a lot of people have this, so if you have this perfume, or this fragrance mist rather, it's not a perfume, you know what I'm talking about. It smells really nice. It's really long lasting. I love to layer this with other scents, and I love to just mix this with perfumes, even throw it in my bag when I'm going to the gym. I use this just to make sure I'm smelling good in the gym. Even to sleep at night, I love to use fragrance mist when I'm going to bed, because I'm a really big scent person and I love smelling good even to go to bed. Yeah, so this is the last thing from my Bath and Body Works haul. And yeah, so I did get a good deal. And shopping on Bath and Body Works from Nigeria is not easy. So what I do is when I want to purchase, I load up my account, I put in all my details. So what I do is I ship to a US address, not Nigerian address. Then I go to Amazon and I purchase a gift card for the exact amount that I'm going to pay. That is inclusive of shipping and tax. Make sure that you get to the point where you have to put in like your card details. By then it would have included like tax and everything. So you know the total amount that you're gonna pay. You go to Amazon, you search for Bath and Body Works gift card email delivery. Purchase the exact amount of your total and email it to yourself. You get a code and then you impute that code and it will deduct it from the gift card. That's how I purchase on Bath and Body Works and Sephora, and I don't have any problems. But just make sure that you're shipping to a US home address, most importantly, Sephora won't ship to like a cargo company or something. It has to be a home address. So yeah, that's how I purchase all these. I do this once a year, sometimes maybe twice. If they're having like a mid-year sale or they're having a really good sale, I just buy additional because it's always a steal. And even purchasing these candles in Nigeria, I think one goes for about 15,000 or 16,000 naira, but this at 9.99, and if I'm saying 750, if I'm using like a 750 exchange rate, that's like 7,000 something, which is still a good price. I know there's shipping inclusive, but when I ship down, I do ship with other things, so it's not that expensive, and I still save a lot of money. So yeah, that's that for that one. And now to the last two items. Okay, so the last two items, I have two sunglasses from Fendi. I'm a big eyewear lover. I love shades, and I like to buy them, I like to wear them, and yeah, so I got two, and I'll just show you guys quickly what I got. So this is the first one. I have worn these, by the way, so it has all the cards and all the information and leaflets inside. I'll just keep this aside. This is what the pouch looks like. It says Fendi, it's a drawstring pouch, and it has like what's this thing called, I can't remember, but yeah, so this is what it looks like. And the sunglasses are inside. I have worn them twice, and yeah, it's just gold rimmed. It's a gold rimmed square sunglass, and around the edges it has the double F's around the perimeter of the sunglasses, very subtly. It's not loud, it's not in your face. I really like it. It's a simple eyewear, nothing too fancy. Yeah, so that's that for that one. I think I've messed up my makeup. Okay, I didn't do too much damage to my makeup, it's still fine. And for the second box, I have this inside. It has all the information as well. We're not gonna go through that. And it comes in the same purse. This is this one yellow? Okay, yeah. So this is slightly different. So this has the Fendi in yellow, and this has the Fendi in like a gray color. Comes with a nice black pouch as well. I like this one, and I have worn these. These are very unique though. These are pink, and on the hand it says Fendi. Very cool sunglasses. This won't do a lot of sun protecting, but I mean, these are just for fancy. They're just cool, they're just chic, and yeah, I really like them, so I got them. It says Fendi by the side. These ones are quite loud, but I don't mind. I wanted pink sunglasses, and I was glad when I found these. I think these are currently sold out on the website, but yeah, these are what they look like. It's giving fly gal. They're just really simple but really cute, very chic. I see myself rocking this with an all black look, and then the glasses just for some contrast. Let me take these off. Yeah, okay. Yeah guys, so that's that for the video. I hope you like everything that I shared. If you're a candle lover, if you're a sunglass lover, if you're a skincare lover, leave a comment below, let me know what you like, and yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. I don't have much to say, but thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Bye.